Namaskaram. So above tax rates were given. Above tax rates means normal tax rates were given in Annual Finance Act 2019. However, in respect of certain types of income, as mentioned below, Income Tax Act 1961 has prescribed specified rate. So I call this particular income as a special income. And for special income, we are having special rates of tax. And special rates of tax are given in the section. The moment I refer some section, that this tax rate is given under section, that section belongs to Income Tax Act 1961, obviously, and though the rates are called as special income tax rates. Now, we don't apply special income tax rate as we applied normal income tax rate. Usually, we apply special income tax rate outrightly. That means if I say lottery is taxable in India at 30%, and if you won 10,000 rupees lottery, so 10,000 multiplied by 30% flat will be applicable on that lottery income. Okay, so try to remember certain rates of tax. Though you are not supposed to remember, and though you are not supposed to understand the nature of special incomes here, we are going to discuss these things in depth in every chapter which is relevant for that particular tax rate. Here, just I wanted to give you overall idea about that there are certain income tax rates which are special in nature. So in India, we are having 112 as a section from Income Tax Act, which will tax long-term capital gain. Now, this is the normal normal. So this is a normal long-term capital gain tax. So if your father is transferring land or house property or some kind of debentures or something like this, okay, then he has to pay tax rate at the rate of 20% on your capital gain. I'll give you a simple example. If the sale price of your house property is 10 lakh, and the index cost or some cost deduction given by capital gain chapter is 80 lakh. So 100 lakh minus 80 lakh, balance 20 lakh will be taxable at the rate of 20%. So 20% multiplied by 20 lakh will be 4 lakh rupees. This is how you compute your special rate of tax. This is share market tax, share market long-term capital gain. So what do you mean by share market capital gain? So this is equity shares of the company, equity oriented fund or units of business trust, technically STT paid. We call it STT paid. STT is a security transaction tax. Security transaction tax we pay on a recognized stock exchange of India. Recognized stock exchange means NSE, BSE for that matter, you can say. Now, share market is already under taxation system of security transaction tax. We cannot tax more on share market again at a rate of 20%. Therefore, we had to give some concessional rate of tax, and that concessional rate of tax is 10%. And look at the benefit given by share market to us. For assessees like me, because I also trade in share market, but I trade in at very less level, and my capital gain, sometimes it is in couple of hundred or sometimes it is in couple of thousand. So they say if your long term capital gain in share market is up to 1 lakh, you are not supposed to pay even 1 rupee as a tax. If your long term capital gain in a share market exceeds 1 lakh, then only you pay tax, and that too at a concessional rate of 10%. So please try to understand this. In share market, long term capital gain is exempt up to 1 lakh under section 112A, and balance will be taxable at a rate of 10%. To give you an example, if I am earning 1,40,000 as a long term capital gain in a share market on transfer of equity shares, listed equity shares of a company, then out of 1,40,000, 1 lakh would be exempt. Balance 40,000 multiplied by 10%, 4,000 is a tax liability under section 112A. So what about short-term capital gain? Sir, long-term capital gain is taxable at 10%. What about short-term capital gain? So short-term capital gain in again a share market, again in recognized stock exchange, again in recognized stock exchange where STT has been paid. STT is a security transaction tax that we pay in a recognized stock exchange. Okay, so if you are suffering with you are having a short-term capital gain, so you are not supposed to pay your higher tax rate. That will be a suffering for you. Why that would be suffering? Because normal tax rate in a country is a 30%, and people who are dealing in a share market, they are deemed to be rich assessees, and they might be having their other income up to 10 lakh, and therefore the short term capital gain from market would have become taxable at the rate of 30%. Government said no, we should not take tax at the rate of 30%, because already we are taking STT. It might fall under double taxation system, and therefore they are giving us concessional rate of 15% on stock exchange security that you are trading in a recognized stock exchange. So long term is exempt up to 1 lakh, balance will become taxable at a rate of 10%. So long term enjoy more benefit than short term, and in share market you become, your asset become long term within a period of just 1 year. So if you are having holding capacity, and please sell your assets or please share your shares at least after 1 year of period of holding. Either you will get exemption up to 1 lakh rupees, and even if you are exposed to tax, you will expose to tax at a rate of 10%. This is what we call it tax planning. If there is a choice given to assessee that you may pay tax at 15% and you may pay tax at 10%, by giving a consultancy, a right amount of consultancy, we can reduce a tax liability of particular assessee. Yeah. So it is not advisable to have a short-term capital gain in the market. You are advisable to have long-term capital gain in market. More benefit about long-term capital gain we will discuss in capital gain chapter. Here just you are, I'm trying to give you an introduction to special tax rate. 115 BB. BB I have remembered as if Bada Bazigar. Bada Bazigar means big better, person who puts bettings in market. So he bets on lot of things like lotteries, crossword puzzle, races including horse races, card game, gambling, you know, Dream 11, Teen Patti. There are a lot of variations about it. If you have that kind of income, there is no concession of even 1 rupee. Direct flat 30% tax rate you are supposed to pay. From share market, we can earn two types of income. One is the dividend if you continued to be a shareholder of particular company. You'll get dividend on year-on-year basis. And if you sell the asset, you will get short-term and long-term capital gain. We have already discussed rate of short-term capital gain as 15%. And tax rate of long-term capital gain in share market is 10% above 1 lakh. Now, what is the tax rate of dividend in India? So technically, you need to remember one more section here. That is section 1034. Okay. Section 1034 exempts. Okay. Section 1034 exempts dividend from domestic company up to 10 lakh. So dividend from domestic company up to 10 lakh is not taxable at all in India. If you are having dividend income more than 10 lakh, for that you need to be a super rich assessee of the market. Okay. If you are earning dividend more than 10 lakh, then the excess will become taxable. Exceeding, that means only excess will become taxable at a rate of 10%. To give an example again here, if you are earning income of 13 lakh rupees as a dividend, from aggregate amount of dividend in particular financial year or previous year 1920, out of 13 lakh rupees, 10 lakh rupees is exempt and balance 3 lakh rupees will be taxable at a rate of 10%. Again, the logic behind is this: we pay dividend distribution tax before we earn dividend in India. Company which is going to give us tax is already paying dividend distribution tax, and corporates are already paying dividend distribution tax to the extent of 20% approximately. And therefore, government don't want to take tax on dividend again from the shareholder. Otherwise, it will lead to a double taxation situation in country. Therefore, they are exempting dividend up to 10 lakh, but they are not exempting dividend above 10 lakh. Above 10 lakh, it is taxable at a concessional rate of 10%. If this concessional rate was not there, this dividend would have become taxable at the rate of 30%, which is the highest lab rate we are having. That concession is given because companies are paying dividend distribution tax. We will discuss this in depth in chapter called IFOS. I spoke about all these things because there are certain students who have already attended lectures of mine who are going to write examination in this June 20. And therefore, you can easily correlate with whatever I'm speaking. Okay. The tax rate of 115 BBE I had already discussed, which is applicable to section 68, 69, 69A, 69B, 69C, 69D, which is called as aggregation of income or anti-black money sections. Okay, undisclosed income. Tax rate here is, okay, tax rate here is, you can see 60%, then add 25% surcharge and 4% sales. Some students do mistake in computing this effective rate of tax. They do 60 plus 25 plus 4 and then they give some weird amount of taxation to me. This surcharge of 25% is on 60. So if you wanted to compute 78%, follow my instruction. Take 60 on your calci, 60, number 60. 60 plus, okay, 25%, you need to put button of percentage. So 60 plus 25%, which will come approximately 75%, and then on that you need to add 4%. So the effective rate of tax on the black money or undisclosed money or unexplained money is 78%, and we don't provide any basic exemption limit, no set off, flat 78% you are supposed to pay. This is the only tax rate. You are, apart from that, you are supposed to pay penalty, and prosecution can happen. That is depending upon case to case basis. Okay, so these are the certain special rates of tax. Look, let's have one more time look from the handwritten notes. So general rates of tax are given in, please understand, general rates of tax are given in Annual Finance Act, whereas special rates of tax are given in Income Tax Act, and the range of the section that we have discussed in our summary of income tax sections lecture, that 110 to 115, approximately 110 to 115, this is the range of the section in which these special rates are mentioned. Some of them just now we have discussed. Short-term capital gain in a share market, STT paid, is a taxable at a concessional rate of 15%, okay. Long-term capital gain, which is the normal on house property, jewelry, land, okay, is a taxable under section 112 directly at 20%. Long-term capital gain in a share market, which is STT paid, again, okay, up to 1 lakh there is no tax, above 1 lakh there is a tax rate of 10%. We will discuss this in depth in capital gain chapter. Casual income we will discuss in IFOS, but here we had just referred the tax rate of 30%, because I'll be using this as a reference point in the chapters about which are about to come. Then there is the aggregation of income, which is the black money, anti-black money section 115 BBE. Our tax rate is 60% plus 25% surcharge plus 4% cess, which comes to an effective rate of 78%. Dividend is the taxable under section 115 BBDA, we call it 115 BABDA, BBDA, okay, 115 BBDA, and tax rate is 10%, but this is applicable above 10 lakh because the dividend is exempt up to 10 lakh in India. There is something called royalty income also under section 115 BBE, sorry, BBF, okay. Royalty income, because government of India is encouraging digital India, startup India, they are encouraging innovation in India as of now. They wanted to give some tax benefit to the resident SSCs who are having a patent registered on their name and they are earning royalty income. So we don't want to harass them by putting an extraordinary burden of tax of 20% and 30% on their head. So we have given them concessional rate of 10%. So these are the special rates of tax. People who are watching this lecture for the first time, they are just supposed to remember some basic special rates like lottery, like capital gain, long-term capital gain and short-term capital gain. Balancing we will discuss in respective chapter. Thank you.